Everyone, my name is Harshita Jain and I'm currently an intern at Lexus & Company. Today I'm going to talk about insider trading. So first of all, what is insider trading? It is defined as a malpractice wherein a trade of a company's securities is undertaken by people who by virtue of their work have access to the information which is otherwise non-public, which can be crucial for making investment decisions. The first country to make a law against insider trading was America. In India, the first effort to address this problem was made in 1947 by the establishment of the Thomas Committee. The recommendations of the committee were later codified under various provisions of the Companies Act of 1956. Soon, with the evolution of the corporate sector, came in the establishment of the Securities and Exchange Board of India, that is SEBI. In 1988. In 1992 came in the SEBI Act along with SEBI prohibition of insider trading in India. The laws kept on becoming stricter and tighter with time in order to cover every loophole available. In 2015 came in a major development when the SEBI brought in the SEBI prohibition of insider trading regulation act in 2015, which replaced the older regulations of 1992 and addressed most of the problems of the older regulation. In 2018, SEBI formed a committee under the chairmanship of Mr. Vishwanathan to take a deeper look into the problems of the new regulations and give its recommendations. On the receiving committee's reports, the SEBI made the latest amendments to these regulations in 2019, which are now the present laws against insider trading in India. If there are any doubts, any questions, do mention them in the comment box. Now I'm going to discuss the provisions related to insider trading in India. The relevant provisions which govern insider trading in India are sections 195 of the Companies Act of 2013 along with section 12A and 15G of the SEBI Act 1992. In addition to these provisions, the primary regulations which cover insider trading in India are the SEBI prohibition of insider trading regulations of 2015. The prohibition and exception to insider trading can be found in the SEBI regulations of 2015. Section 12A, subclause D of the SEBI Act 1992 expressly prohibits insider trading, while section 15G imposes a penalty of a sum ranging between 10 lakhs to 25 crore rupees of a penalty of a sum which is, three times the amount of the profit made, whichever of the two is higher. Section 195 of the Companies Act of 2013 also prohibits insider trading in addition to defining what it is and states that a punishment of 5 years of imprisonment and or a fine of up to 25 crores may be imposed on the defaulter. Regulations 3, sub-regulation 1 of the SEBI prohibition of insider trading regulations 2015 lays down the first prohibition on insider trading and states that no insider shall communicate any UPSI relating to a company to any person. The term any person here also includes other insider of the company as well. Hence, it states that a person who is in possession of a UPSI shall neither communicate such UPSI to outsiders or insiders. However, it also carves an exception and states that such disclosure of information may be allowed in cases where such communication is made for, legitimate purposes like performance of duties or discharge of legal obligations. On the recommendations of the Vishwanathan Committee, a few examples of legitimate exceptions, were added wherein such disclosure in ordinary course of business to partners, collaborators, etc. would fall under this exception. However, under Regulation 2B, it also states that any such person to whom UPSI is disclosed for a legitimate purpose to lawyers or accountants, partners, from that point will fall under the definition of insider. And hence all the prohibitions of the regulation would apply to them as well. So this concept can be seen to have been borrowed from the US concept of constructive insiders as laid down in the case of Dirks versus SEC. This case stated that any such person like lawyers, accountants, etc. who are actually outsider will be construed as insiders from the point at which the UPSI was shared with them, you know. So in another exception to this prohibition is carved out in the subregulation 3 of regulation 3, wherein the UPSI is permitted to be disclosed or allowed access to in two circumstances. Firstly, in the case where due to takeover regulations, obligations to make an open offer arise and the BOD is informed opinion that doing so would be the best interest of the company. Now, second case is wherein the obligation arise. However, the BOD feels that disclosing such information would be in the best interest of the company. In the second case, the UPSI about a transaction should be made public at least 2 days prior the said transaction takes place. The important thing to be noted here is that in both such cases, the disclosure has to be made to the entire public and not a selective group of people. Hence, it purports to the motive of the regulation, which is to avoid the unlawful gain by a few people. Now, an important point regarding this prohibition was highlighted by the SAT in its judgment of Sameer Arora versus SEBI. Here, Sameer Arora was accused of disclosing certain UPSI about a merger, eventually making a profit for himself. So, however, it was later found out that the information disclosed by him was false or uncertain, as at the day of disclosure, no such merger decision had taken place. The SAT ruled that since the information was false, the prohibition of non-disclosure won't be attracted, as the information has to be true to constitute a UPSI and to attract a charge of insider trading. The second prohibition against insider trading is laid down in Regulation 3, Sub-Regulation 2, which prohibits any person, that is insider or outsider, from procuring any UPSI related to a company. This prohibition goes in tandem with the first prohibition and restricts any person from getting access to UPSI regarding a company. The same exception of legitimate purpose has been carved out in this provision as well. Tandem here means like along with, jaise first provision mein hota hai, waise hi similarly is second provision mein hota hai. Now the third and the most important exception is laid down in regulation 4, which prohibits any person in possession of UPSI of a listed company from trading in securities of that company on the stock market. It was held by SAT in the case of Chandrakala versus SEBI that if an insider deals in securities while in possession of UPSI, then it would be presumed that he or she traded on the basis of the UPSI. However, six exceptions have been carved out in this particular prohibition in Regulation 4. Firstly, an exception has been made for an offer market interstate transaction. Second, the block deal window mechanism falls under the exception. Third is the exception wherein the trading took place under the statutory of regulatory obligations. The fourth exception allows transactions which are in furtherance of stock options. Fifth exception applies to, you know, non-individual insiders in states that when a group of insiders where some possess UPSI deal together. Here it should be proved that the insiders who actually took the trading decisions were not in possession of UPSI and were different entities from those possessing such UPSI. Lastly, an exception is created for trades conducted on the basis of the trading plans. Now, it would be safe to conclude that insider trading is no more a white-collar crime. Countries across the globe have taken, you know, stringent measures to check and prevent on practices of, you know, insider trading. It is high time for India to implement such measures for the person who have been found guilty and not treat insider trading just as a white collar crime, as there is only a less than 3% conviction rate in such crimes. In India, there is a need to amend the regulations and to add strict criminal procedures and awards against, you know, such offences. There is also be another regulatory body along with the SCBI to track down high profile cases and to, you know, prevent such sensitive information from flowing in the market. Further, as the number of cases are increasing every year, the Indian judiciary needs to set up a fast track courts for, you know, certain high profile cases that involve huge stake of the market, as it would, you know, save the investors and the market's money, but would also curb the illegal practice of insider trading. So if there are any questions regarding this video or the previous video or anything, do mention them in the comment box. Thank you for watching.